Oh, you know what I could go for right now, that big Chicago cut steak, a side of au gratin potatoes, the shrimp cocktail, maybe a platter of oysters. What am I talking about? I'm talking about the best eating in the city of Chicago. Carmichael's, the Chicago Steakhouse, 1052 West Monroe Street. Meanwhile, game time, long ball time, and daily Coppock time. How you doing, everybody? This is beyond crazy. A local writer over the weekend wrote that the National Football League club owners and the players are now engaged in a game of chicken. A game of chicken? Did I miss something? Does training camp open up in 3 days? This is a labor negotiation. They've had mediation. They've made a little bit of progress. This is far from being a game of chicken right now, for heaven's sakes. Hey, the National Football League and former Commissioner Paul Tagliabue know they signed a lousy contract with the players back in 2006. Now they're trying to rectify it to so-called even up the playing field. Hey, the fact of the matter is, though, you're not going to find any National Football League club owner who's ever going to miss a meal. You heard it from Coppock. This will end on or before July 24th. The National Football League will miss two exhibition games, of which the public will not give a darn, full and complete. All right, he is colorful. He is outrageous. He is a book of knowledge on his beloved 1967 Boston Red Sox, and he is arguably the greatest homer, the greatest single homer on the face of the earth. He is also the godfather of the Hawk Walk, and you know what? He's a baseball treasure in my opinion. Who am I talking about? I featured him in my book, The Best-Selling Fat Guys Shouldn't Be Dancing at Halftime, Hawk Harrelson. Now, contemplate all the years the Hawk has been broadcasting White Sox baseball. Now, let's go 8 miles north. Suppose Hawk had been the longtime voice of the Chicago Cubs, even sidekicking with Harry Carey. It says here, given the benefit of what I call the John McDonough marketing machinery, Hawk Harrelson right now would be a member of baseball's Hall of Fame. This is the very essence of what Hawk is all about. Free-spirited and quotable. Hawk in Fat Guys told me regarding the North Side-South Side rivalry, I love to piss off Cub fans. I want them to know one thing when we play them, I want to kick their ass. You know what, Hawk? I'm a Cub fan, but you, Hawk, are a baseball treasure. This is not the worst gimmick in the world, but it's got to be among the top five. When are the Chicago Bulls going to get rid of their blubbergut dance team known as the Matadors? What are the Matadors? In my opinion, it's a lousy act, number one. And number two, it's nothing more than a living, breathing advertisement for heart failure, kidney failure, and a complete inability to sit in a middle seat while flying on an aircraft. Steve Shanwald, you're a bright guy, the longtime vice president of marketing over at the United Center for the Bulls. Please get rid of these guys. Watch the act. Nobody laughs. Nobody applauds. The Matadors are a complete waste of time. Well, you know what? They still have the Medill School of Journalism, and they still have head football coach Pat Fitzgerald. What they don't have is the big dance on their resume. This is almost unfathomable, almost unbelievable. Keep in mind, we're talking about a Big Ten school. Do you realize the NCAA tournament began way back in 1939? Since then, the Northwestern Wildcats have appeared in the NCAA tournament a grand total of 0, aught, zilp, zitch, nada. The Wildcats have never received an invitation. In fact, the White Sox, or make that the Wildcats rather, are not that far away from being able to utilize a phrase that has become part of the tradition of the Chicago Cubs, that being any ball club can have a bad century. You know, this doesn't exactly scream scalper or rush out to get your World Series tickets. Do you ever check in with VegasInsider.com? It's one of my favorite sites on the web. Talking about baseball futures, the odds to win the World Series in 2011, the Cubs are listed at 50-1. Frankly, given the defensive brilliance of Alfonso Soriano, I would have the Cubs at about 175-1. As for the White Sox, Vegas right now isn't waving banners in their direction either. The Sox are listed at 35-1 to capture baseball's classic. Now, I do think the White Sox will win the American League Central. They will take care of Garden Hire. They will take care of the Piranhas, which should tell you, as it tells me, that somehow Jake Peavy's arm is going to be good for at least 25 starts. All right, after months and months of buildup and an overdose on ESPN, I finally have Coppock's Final Four, the Final Four that truly matters, the Final Four that involves imagination and the dreams of upsets occurring on the road to Houston. Here is the Daily Coppock Final Four. Pittsburgh, easiest path down to the Lone Star State. Matt Painter and the Purdue Boilermakers. North Carolina, I know they got their butts kicked by Duke the other day. Forget about it. That's going to be ancient history in a week. And my real dark horse for the tournament, San Diego State. So, Pittsburgh, Purdue, North Carolina, San Diego State. Meanwhile, as we close out this edition of the Daily Coppock, this is just one great song done by a fabulous rock and roll group that I thought was going to be a 21st century knockout punch. Now I have absolutely no idea what they're doing. They may be flipping hamburgers on Long Island for all I know. Do you remember the New Radicals? The New Radicals, you only get what you give. Hey, before we get to that song, I want you to get you and your bride or you and your girlfriend or you and your buddies down to Carmichael's during the tournament. Enjoy basketball sitting in their luxurious bar. Have a couple of martinis, maybe a couple of long necks. Then dive into a big steak or maybe have a big slab of ribs or enjoy their seafood. Do it Coppock style. Make sure you have the carrot cake. Have a shot at Drambuie before you leave. Do it Carmichael style. Why? Because Carmichael's, the Chicago Steakhouse, is the best steakhouse in the entire Windy City. This has been the Daily Coppock. We'll catch you next time around. Until then, so long, everybody.
You won't go to see the Bulls emblem shade in somebody's back and a 400-pound man do a split. How you gonna put that through?